Jones.
Right. Very exciting.
We got Mike Tyson coming out of retirement. He gonna fight a
exhibition eight round
bout against another legendary boxer, Roy Jones Jr. So this is taking place. When is this taking place? August, I believe.
Like last week of August, 20-some, I think I was seeing.
September 12th.
September.
Okay. I gave him a couple months. He been practicing already.
They already been training. Both of them already been training because they know about the fight before we do.
Yeah, so it's July. Yeah, it gives them about 2 months.
Mike been training for about a month and a half.
Already, yeah. Shit, I don't know what he thinking.
So, I'm real excited about this. I'm happy it's not Mike against.
That boy's still up there. With
I'm
him.
Glad it's not Mike against Holyfield like people was pushing for. Mm-hmm. I like the Shannon Briggs match for Brooklyn. Mm-hmm. Brownsville shit. I really like that. A lot of people probably ain't even really understand that. I think it'll happen. But him and Roy, that's a ticket seller.
That's exactly what it is, a ticket seller, because they both legends.
And Roy is Roy.
Roy, yeah, Roy still got them hands. Let's not act like he ain't got them hands. I don't know, though. I like Mike in this fight.
Looking at Mike and seeing him move and hit that bag, because I'm a fan of Mike, bro. I love him.
Yeah, he's still
I actually used to be able to, you know, do this, reach. He used to be out here, bro, like at his peak and shit. So Mike was, like,
yeah, I saw him downtown.
You know what I mean? So, seeing him move in them sparring sessions, the hips, the knee.
Looking at the shit right now, he just he's still fit. His body's still fit. And you know the bud, smoking all that bud throughout this time helps his body recovery. You know what I'm saying? So, I don't know. I just think he's more focused than he's ever been when he was younger. Just when you hear Mike talk, because I watch the Hot Box sometimes here and there. I don't watch it all the time, but I watch it here and there. He's just more calm now. He's
more stable.
Yeah, he's like a calm beast now. Like
he's like the opposite of, like, you know, like to compare it like that, but like how we saw my ex, how ex life has always been a struggle, even when he got to the top and all that. Same shit with Mike, but it's like Mike then went through it, and he's grown to you know, accept his life. You know what I'm saying? So I know that he's still blessed to have a chance at another day. So he takes advantage of it. And I think he's just in a good headspace. And it's not being forced upon him. He wants to do this. So I got him knocking Roy the fuck out.
I said all that to say that. I got him knocking him out too. I got him winning. It's probably gonna be like in six.
Could be the second round, bro.
I think it's gonna be a good match. So
I don't know.
I don't know neither, but I would like. I'm excited to see it because I've been watching.
I don't know if it's gonna be good, but it's good. It's like when you look at Mike Tyson, Roy Jones, you're gonna watch.
Yeah. If they fighting other opponents, that's the draw, them two. So now you got them together in the same ring. So I just think it's going to be a great match.
I want Roy to get knocked out because he be talking hot in the boxing commentary shit. You know what I'm saying? I remember what Lynn Johnson did to him.
Yeah.
Yeah, right.
So, I like Roy Jones, though. He's nice.
It's my man. But we talking about Iron Mike.
Iron Mike gonna knock that nigga out.
You gonna put him the fuck out, bro. We got an undercard on that too, right? One battle.
We got a nice undercard with Jake Paul from YouTube, the YouTuber, y'all know him, against Nate Robinson, former Knicks player, you know what I'm saying? 3-time dunk champion, you know what I'm saying? I don't know that. I got Nate in that.
I got Nate fuck him up. I've seen Nate hands, bro.
Yeah, I've seen him fight before. And I've seen Jake Paul fight before. And he got knocked out by that other YouTuber.
Mm-hmm.
KSI or something like that.
Yeah, I remember that.
The black dude.
Uh-huh.
Can't fight. He like to fight black people because he racist, but he get fucked up every time.
Nate got hands, man. He one of them, you know how that is. He one of them little dudes, and he fit.
Yeah, we stay low to the ground.
Mm-hmm. We gonna put that nigga out. He might lift him up.
Yeah, I got him taking that. I hope.
Let's go, Nate.
What they gonna do? Most of this shit probably be a pay-per-view.
Hopefully they put it on ESPN. Hopefully it's some streaming shit. But, I mean, it depends on who's going to pick it up. I think Fox Sports will always pick it up.
Yeah, I like to see it on ABC or something.
Fox Sports will always pick it up. You'll catch it on Fox Sports channel, one of the brother channels or something like that. Fox Sports is, look, you see URL up there, man. Yeah. You mean commercials and all that. So I can see them picking up that exhibition because there's money to be made there. Somebody going to pick it up. I don't see ESPN picking it up. Even though they should be in the climate that we're in.
Remember, right before this shit started going down, all this quarantine shit, a lot of boxing matches, remember they did deal with NBC? They were starting to put it back on regular TV.
Uh-huh. But so, this ain't no sanctioned fight.
Yeah. It's going to be in a bubble just like everything else. Just, no fight. You seen them fights that they had? They just had the fights. They had a couple fights.
Yeah, you're
they
sure. Just had,
no, boxing.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You see the dude? I forget his name. He just went 14-0. He from New York, too. Mm-hmm. 14-0 with 14 knockouts. All his knockouts is within two rounds.
But in an empty little room.
Yeah, I keep forgetting his name, though. So where I want to go after this, because the boxing shit is very interesting. I would like to see Mike Tyson do what he doing that.